a team, and our customer is the constituents out there, the citizens, and they're expecting us to do a job. And if we can work well, you know, because I've been here for 4 years, and it seems like we're always, everybody's got in their own little huddles. I get tired of that. Let's try to bring some common ground here, and if we can, I appreciate what Councilmember Lutz just said. Let's find out what's going to work, what we can do, and let's do it. Because you know what? If we can save as many jobs as possible, I think we're mandated to do that. I do need to let you know that as council members, as elected officials, we are responsible for making these critical decisions. And of course, as you well know, there's going to be some critical decisions that have to be made, but at least we can make that with well-informed information coming from the employees. So please, let's continue that. If there's any concerns, you know, the city manager is here to work with you, Mr. Jim Pia as well, with the Public Works, and we're here also if we can be of service. So thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Tony. Anyone else? Gloria.
I also want to say that I'm glad that we're having this dialogue with our employees. I had some questions on the why aren't we using the mechanic, that expensive piece of equipment. But I also looked at the ideas that you have given us, and they're good ideas. I also want to know how many, I don't play golf, but I'm not sure how many golf courses we have. I'd like to know that information. And I really liked the idea about raising fees. I've been one of those that, because of the constant community members that don't know how to abide the ordinances, especially when it comes to, again, you know, illegal contractors and so forth, especially in the LaSalle area, and the repeated offenders, and just so many other things that we can look to raise the fees. And I've been, you know, I've had constant dialogue sometimes with our city manager about that we need to, sometimes we're funny as individuals, they have to get us in our pocket. Like if you park in a handicap, you know, it's a certain fine, and believe me, you're not going to park there again. And I think we need to look at the at those fees, and I'm surprised at the 50 acres. I know it's a big golf course, but I didn't realize how big it was, you know, and that there is some good things that we could do in some of our parks. So again, thank you for your recommendations.
Okay. Steve.
Yeah, great insights. I'm surprised that these weren't brought forward earlier, but you know, moving forward, we're going to need input. And I think tonight this is really encouraging. We have a lot of great ideas. I look forward to the analysis. We got a $7 million hole plus. And as we face this next year through the budget process, we need to invite people to be involved in all the ideas they can bring forward. One thing I would just caution at is fees. We could, on two levels. One level, we can't charge more than it costs to provide the service. I mean, otherwise we'd be a going concern, we'd be a business. So we have to keep that in mind. Beyond that as well, it's a marketplace. And as we're trying to attract businesses alongside thousands of other cities out there that want to have good, clean jobs, as we've heard from our economic development director, and certainly as we've heard from our CFO, you know, we want that sales tax revenue. We've got to keep in mind, you know, fees can really deter that marketplace of other businesses. But great presentation, Ray, Christy. Thank you for your participation, and Andy as well. And I look forward to more dialogue there.
Thank you, Steve. Sergio.
You know, for those that supported you coming forward, and the offer was made to everybody that wanted to, and I appreciate you taking us. One, you asked, and we did, and at least the majority of this council, all of us decided that we wanted to hear you after everything that went through the last week. So, but one thing that I'm really appreciative is that you did not come here and say, like some people have, some units have come here and said, we're sacred cows, take them out first before me, because you can't politically lay me off. And I really appreciate that, because you came here with minimum really good ideas, minimum. But some of them I think they're very feasible, some of them are great ideas, and some of them we should have done them long time ago, which lets me know that we're not doing enough listening. You know, I think when we talk about this little forms that we say, you know, let us know what you're thinking or how we. I don't think we really take it seriously. I think we should hear from the public. We should hear from all of you, because you do the work and making decisions in the absence of your input. I think it makes no sense for any business. Business does it all the time. They always ask employees, "What do you guys think? We need to reduce costs. How do we do it?" And usually the good solutions comes from there. You know, I never seen great solutions come from one person or a couple of people. Usually comes from a group. So really appreciate you not taking, because you could have said that. You could have said, lay off a whole bunch of cops, or let's cut this, let's cut that, and you didn't do that. You really care about the community, at least you showed in your presentation, because I, for one, was expecting a little bit of that. You didn't put none of it in there. You just said, this is some budget dust that you can pick up if you would actually tighten up. And I tell you, at one time, when times were good, I hire my friend to come and cut my yard because he had a little business. After a while, we couldn't pay them. My son took it over. My son moved out. I took it over. You know what I'm saying? So it's at one time or whatever, times change, and I think we need to figure out how internally we can do that. City of Hollister put a lot of money out there for a while to get people to get certifications, to move up. Okay, if you don't have a high school diploma, get a high school diploma. If you have an A degree, they get a BA degree. And if you have this certification, get another one. Get certified to do fire pumps and do all kinds of stuff and figure out, because the more people have opportunities, and I know people will go to school and get their certification if they're allowed to do so, and if there's incentives, and I think this city hasn't had that for a long time. So we got to really rethink that, because I think there's opportunities there for us to provide better services, to improve ourselves internally. Again, I'm cutting the yard now, and at one time I had my friend doing it because I could afford it. So, you know, just some of us are going now on paper, in a paper diet, other than the documents that we were given today by you guys and the city staff, I don't get no more paper. And as a result of that, it saved money, you know, I hope NCAM and the rest of the staff at the city clerk's office appreciates that, because now they don't have to do all those big old binders and those stuff and then throw it all away or recycle it. That's a lot of expenditure. So, you know, I don't want to take all credit for that, but, you know, that was an idea that came and nobody asked me to bring my idea. I brought it and I keep pushing it for years, and somebody finally already listened and said, let's try it. Let's make you the guinea pig. And I appreciate, you know, from Scott Golden and everybody else that's been working on this part, but look at some of us, this desk don't have as much paper as we used to. So I think we got to do more of the listening and less of the talking, like I'm doing now, because I think a lot of good ideas come up from that. And so I appreciate you taking the high road, bringing some great ideas, and we should encourage you. You shouldn't have to ask us to do that. We should, as leaders of the city, we should always ask you and have you come up here in the public, because you know what you do out there. And, you know, I don't want to come out that this thing, there's a gopher gate or some other kind of gate, but, you know, there's just some things that just don't make sense to me. And I think having you tell us publicly and privately, I think that should always happen, and you should never be afraid to share with us. And so I'm certainly supportive of continuing to look at all this stuff. I think it should be brought back in the way of a matrix that actually justifies, not just say, oh, we don't think it's a good idea, let's toss it. I think justify and say why and why not, and what would be the actual savings. I mean, I think we have great staff that can do that and figure out how, if it really saves us money, even if it's a dollar, we should take a look and not dismiss any idea. So appreciate that. You know, hopefully when we have this next piece that's coming up, hopefully we'll take this in consideration, because making decisions based on all this that you just provided, it doesn't make sense for us to make decisions if we just got some more information that potentially could be saving. So thank you for taking the high road. Thank you for your comments and for taking us on. I mean, because it's easier to come and say, hey, you know, I don't have no problems. I love Artie. He always listens listens to me, I have no problems. Good for you. But when you do have ideas, come to us and come publicly. I think that's a good thing to do.
Okay, thank you, Sergio. Jill?
Well, I think I made my comments, and that was thank you, first of all, for being here. Appreciate the comments, mm-hmm. and again, asking staff to come back with responses.
Okay, thank you. I think Sergio is correct in pointing out that there was complete agreement that we want to hear ideas from all quarters in the city, and obviously folks who are close to the work on a daily basis. I will continue to maintain there is a process and a time and a place, and folks of goodwill may have disagree how, when, and where that occurs, but the important thing is everyone understands the nature of the problem, the scope of the problem, and the fact, as Councilmember Barrera said, we do need to be together to work through the problem. There are no bad ideas, or ideas are welcome from all quarters. Some may work, some may not. Some are a matter of process and and some, frankly, have political considerations. You know, I might, for the record, occasionally know. I know I often disappoint my father. You know, the proverbial God rest his soul. When I seemingly support libraries over parks, I would be remiss if I didn't note, at least for the record. You want to talk about a tempest in a teapot, have a conversation about a golf course and whether it's 9 holes or 18 holes. And I say that without taking any sides on the issue, but to say people feel, and I think this is a good thing, strongly about many of the elements they're familiar with in this community, whether it's the libraries, the golf course, the Tividad Creek Park. And so that's one of the best things we have going for us as we go through this exercise, that people are going to really, I think, fight in a very positive manner for the things they believe in, and we can't be afraid to have those sometimes tough around here, pretty always spirited dialogues to get to where we need to get to. So I think everybody is in complete agreement. We need to hear all good ideas and make sure that everyone feels welcome in the table. So I think tonight was a good exercise from that standpoint. I appreciate the three groups that took the time to come forward, and I think it is important to note this is going to be an ongoing dialogue in this city for years to come. How you redesign, reform, and refinance the city. You know, what are the roles of the cities? There is something much more fundamental going on. It's really how do cities move forward in the future and bridge the gap between the services we know the public expects and how do you pay for that? And that frankly is in jeopardy and it's wobbly. So we're going to be talking about budgets for a while, but in the meantime we've got a tough 60 to 120 days in front of us, and it's good to know the community will be paying close attention. That way we get the best answers. So with that, we will go ahead and proceed to the consideration item, and which is I will look for the city manager, and which is basically bringing back the same item we had last week. If you recall, this item was essentially continued to this week with the proviso that those employee groups that wish to address the council would have an opportunity to do that. And now we will consider the item that was on the table last week.
Thank you, Mayor and City Council. You're correct. This item is being carried over from last week. There are two issues that we'll be dealing with tonight. One is the carryover of funds from the fiscal year 09-10 budget, and also our strategy for dealing with the $7 million shortfall coming up. And then thirdly, there are some mid-year corrections that we'd like to make. So first of all, with regard to the carryover from FY 2009-10, the city will be carrying over $1.4 million. About $500,000 of that comes from general fund, and $940,000 comes from Measure V. The carryover is primarily due to hiring freezes that we implemented last year. just to show you how this breaks out, we're receiving, breaks out in terms of how we're going to, we're planning or recommending spending the $1.4 million. As you can see at the top, we have about $700,000 that we've paid out in